In the call this year, Devopedia, we have decided to celebrate Engineers Day. So officially, Engineers Day falls on September 15th. That is how it's celebrated in India. But globally, of course, there is no consensus. You know, which day is Engineers Day? I think you know, many, there are different dates. Some countries celebrate you know, in March, some in April, and so on. I guess in each country, it signifies signifies the birthday of an engineer from that country. So there's no global consensus. In India, it's the birthday of Sir M. Vishveshwaraya, which is falling on September 15th. So as to commemorate that, we are having a series of technical talks starting with today. On the whole, we have scheduled 15 talks. Typically on weekends, we will have more talks. So watch out for this Friday, Saturday, Sunday, we will have a bunch of talks. And the same thing will happen on next weekend as well, the following weekend as well. So today's talk is Introduction to Engineering Design. But before that, let me, some of you may be new to Devopedia. So Devopedia is a platform as well as a community. So as a platform, it is hosted at devopedia.org, where we have a site, you know, which is somewhat inspired by Wikipedia, you can say. So it is similar to Wikipedia in the sense that all the content that is produced online, it's a collaborative in nature. So I may start an article, somebody else may come in and edit that article. So over time, the quality of that article improves. So this is like a typical article on Devopedia. I'm showing an example of an article. So this is a typical article on Devopedia. So this article is IoT security model. And you know, it starts with a summary. Then there is a deeper discussion about the various aspects of this topic. And you know, if you sign up online, then you can start editing this article. And if you are a new author, very new to Devopedia, the edit will go through a couple of moderations. So moderators will see whether the edit is okay. Then they, you know, allow the edit. And the nature of collaborative model is that typically you are encouraged to use the chat room, discuss with the other authors of the article before you go and edit. So that is what we encourage. Otherwise, it causes a lot of friction among the authors. So the recommended way is you discuss the topic, discuss the topics and topics suggestions, and then other authors will comment, and then you can go ahead and, you know, start editing the article. So that is how Devopedia is structured. So if you are new to Devopedia, take a look at a number of articles that we have published on the site. So as a community, we organize, you know, a lot of workshops and talks. Because of COVID, we have been a little slow on that front, but you know, we have used this opportunity of Engineers Day to launch this series of tech talks online. So you can say this is one of the earliest virtual events that we are having. So that's about Devopedia, and we'll go to today's talk, Introduction to Engineering Design. The speaker is Mr. Krishnan. Mr. Krishnan has more than 40 years of experience, mainly in the automotive sector, which means that in today's presentation, he will be using a lot of interesting examples from the automotive sector. So out of this, in this 40 plus years, he has worked in many companies, Ashok Leyland, Usha Telehoist, but primarily most of his experience has been with Escorts Group in Faridabad. Among his skills or responsibilities have been design, engineering training, cost estimation, project planning, you know, those kind of things. Even after retirement, he has been quite active. He has been consulting with different companies, colleges, and also mentoring startups and design engineers. So with this short introduction, I would like to welcome Mr. Krishnan. The session will be for probably 45 to 60 minutes. And after that, you know, there will be chance for people to ask questions. So now I'll move to the slides, and then Mr. Krishnan can take over from here. Mr. Krishnan?
Hello?
Yeah, go ahead.
Hello. Good evening, gentlemen. I am going to introduce you to general engineering design in various fields like automobile, aeronautic, or industrial application, or domestic. In every field, design is a basic thing needed to attract the market and production. So I'll generally give a speech on engineering design, not any IT related or computer related. Next. Okay. The Indian industry evolution, if you see, in the last say 5 decades, in the beginning it was only mainly manufacturing. We used to get the designs from USA, Germany, England, so we were only keen on how to produce it. Just to manufacturing itself was a big challenge at that time. Then the next decade was quality. So every industry was concentrating on the quality aspects, how to improve the quality, how to bring out trouble-free products and reduce the rejections, all this. So the quality was the next decade's concentration. Then came the cost. When everybody is okay in manufacturing, okay in quality, then the cost is a very important factor to compete both local market and export market. So these 10 years are mostly on cost reduction, how to design it for cost, etc. Then the last area is now, having completed all this manufacturing from foreign designs, now we have to start designing for India. Just like electric scooters or cars, like narrow, like that. So the design and innovation became the very important aspect in this 2000 afterwards, up to 20. So everybody has to have a competitive edge, uniqueness, user-friendly design, all these things. So the design has come a center stage, and design is emphasized now. Previously, we were only worried how to make it, then how to maintain the quality, and how to control the cost. Now, design, something innovation in designs is become the center stage now. That is why we have chosen this topic today. This design aspects applicable to any industry. Next slide. Next. Hello. Okay. Sorry, there's a mismatch. Design is a seed corn for industrial growth and economic progress of any nation. More than anything else, the fundamental change in standard of living or the application to new areas, design is a seed corn. That is why Germany and USA are leading in economy. Design is a combination of art and engineering. That I'll tell you in the following slides. Generally, mathematical calculations in the design and artistic expression in the exterior, both is the design's byproducts. Brings out the creative and technical ability. The design brings out the creative and technical ability for improving the lifestyle of people and for convenience of society, and also improve the standard of living. The two facets of engineering designs are innovative original design and creative adaptation. See, innovative original designs come from mostly European countries, but we were good 3000 years back, we also had innovative original designs. Somehow we have lost track during the British and Muslim rules. Otherwise, we were also equally innovative in the beginning. Now we have to adopt the European designs mostly in everything, like from laptop, cell phone, or car, or anything. Then the creative adaptation. The creative adaptation is adapting the original design and modifying it to bring out better performance, reduce the cost, or the application. This is creative adaptation. That's where the Japanese were good in that. I can't say copying. They are only creatively improving that. That is creative adaptation. And we are also good in that, especially our northern friend Jalandhar, Ludhiana, and all these places are very good in Coimbatore copying and creating creative adaptation to local conditions. That's why the innovation original design has started now, especially Bangalore has become the innovative center and the startup hubs. So a lot of new design ideas have come for the conventional things which we do, which has become more modern now. Next slide. Design success stories. For example, the Canadian conveyor equipments and big earth moving equipments, Canada was good. And watches, everybody knows Swiss watches are very famous and very precision and very costly also. Then the Japan walkie-talkie, the Sony invented the walkie-talkie. He thought the big radios, big tape recorders are all how to bring it to hand size and fist size. It can be kept in a pocket. So Sony brought the walkie-talkie, which is a great success. Then the iPod, Apple iPod is a great success about 25 years back, I think. I remember maybe 20 years back iPod came. In a small 1 inch, by 1 inch you can store thousands of songs. That's really a great invention. Then the Italian race cars and sports cars are famous for their design. India is very famous for bi-wheelers. We have even our own Bajaj motorcycle was copied by Chinese, but they failed in that. Then the Korea is good in shipbuilding. They are the number one in, of course, apart from electronics, they are very good in shipbuilding also. Almost they build 1 week, one ship, something like that. China, of course, is mainly copying others' design. Even Americans are worried about that. Their software, hardware are copied from China. But the Chinese are very good in these bullet trains and other things, which was originally started in France and Germany. But they were really doing wonderfully well. Acha. Next is, we talked earlier about engineering design and industrial design. So the engineering design is mostly based on scientific calculation and mathematics. The structural strength, the weight, stress, strain involved, longevity, and the wear and tear, everything. So engineering design is basically a science and maths related analysis to ensure function, safety, cost, durability, all these things are based on engineering calculations. Use of computer, this CAD, CAD, CAM, and the PROE, then CATIA, all these computers were used to speed up the calculations and repeat the thing and modify the designs quickly. In those days, we used to use paper on a drafting board. To modify the drawing will take 1 week. Today, in 10 minutes, you can modify the drawing. So that it has increased the speed of designing and drawing. But basically, it is the engineer's innovative brain which brings the design. But computers are like pens. The poet has to write the poem. Pens only will write it. That's all. But the poet still has to bring the poem. Pen cannot write the poem. Like that, computers are there as an added speeding up the work and calculation, everything. Otherwise, the brain is still the engineer's brain. Then adherence to standards. Again, the standards are all there throughout different countries. So engineering design will address the standards and their calculations and their testing and all. Then matching best manufacturing practices. Engineering design has to address this also, because one part can be manufactured in different methods, but you have to analyze the best method. And so it's engineering design covers this also. But against this, industrial design is more creative and artistic and appealing. Then ensure appeal to customers through texture, color, shape, and form. That's more of a creative aspect of it. This will not be through calculations. Otherwise, everybody will come out with the same design, isn't it? This is a creative idea which comes from the brain of the artist or industrial designer, which is very unique. Then the less this industrial design has got less mathematical approach and calculations and more of imagination and visualization, and also observing the people, observing the need of the people accordingly or ergonomically or whatever. That will go in details, much more detail in the next slides. Okay. Industrial engineering design matrix. The horizontal side shows the engineering design and vertical shows the industrial design. There is more of engineering design in airplanes. Thermodynamics, aerofoil, engine thrust, all these are calculated. So it is all engineering design. The car is partially engineering design and partially industrial design because the external appearance of cars are very important. But it has got engine calculations, temperature, friction, and then the horsepower, transmission, all these are engineering. So it has got both aspects of industrial and engineering design. Then the furnitures and bureaus are mostly industrial design, less of engineering design. Then the spoons, fork, tableware, cup and saucer, all these are mostly industrial design, less of engineering design. I hope it's clear. Next. Okay, any design people have to ask on any at least 100 questions. When I was in Harita TVS, I asked the engineering trainees, I showed a pen and asked them how many questions you can ask on this pen. They only asked what is the cost of the pen, what is the name of the pen, and what is the material. So only three questions they could ask. But I told them you can ask 100 questions on the pen. I also gave an example of maybe 25-30 questions. So any designer has to ask 100 questions. What is the function? What is the material? What is the cost? What is the manufacturability? What is the uniqueness of this pen? Like that, you have to ask at least 100. You can ask, I think we have already asked more than 16-17 questions in this pen itself. But you can ask more questions. So ask a good designer should ask any question. Is it cost effective? Is it able to be used, user friendly? All these things you have to ask. And what is the material used? What material can long last? What is the refillability? All these, that's why you have to ask a lot of questions on any product to become a good designer. Next, please. Okay. This is the main slide. Based on this, we will be discussing in detail. Actually, there is a 360 degrees appraisal of persons in companies, isn't it? For promotions or increment or whatever it is. Similarly, a good designer has to have 360 degrees approach to design. He should satisfy all these things in order to come out with a very good design. It may take a lot of iterations and a lot of modifications, but still fundamentally, these are all the questions any designer should ask. First is the customer need. Is it really required by the customer, or should we introduce a new requirement which will satisfy the customer? Like that, customer is a focus point actually. The next is the user-friendly design. It cannot be complicated with a lot of parts and difficult to handle it. So it should be a user-friendly design. The next is ergonomics. Whether does it give fatigue? A chair designed badly may give you fatigue, or a car steering at the wrong height will give you more difficulty in turning. So human ergonomics is very important in both safety, handling, endurance and all. So that's a very important aspect. Wherever there is a human involved, human element involved, like airplane, handbrake position, like that. Then serviceability. Serviceability is very important Because if the car or anything breaks down in the road, if you cannot service it properly through the mechanic or otherwise, or you can't change the wheel because of bad designs of bolt or fixing arrangement and all. So serviceability is very, very important aspect. Then comes off-the-shelf parts. You don't reinvent a bolt or some word is there for the reinvent anything, reinvent a spoon or whatever it is. Off-the-shelf parts you should use. That reduces the cost of the production, cost of the, so don't reinvent anything, don't reinvent the wheel. I forgot, I'm an old man, I forget the words. So off-the-shelf parts you should try to use as far as possible. This is also revolving economy is coming nowadays. So you should try to use the existing parts as long as possible, as far as possible. Then the cost, that's one of the basic element in India, because in a car showroom, if an American goes, he will see the external design of the car. The German will open the bonnet and see the engine, how the engine is working. Japanese will go and see the quality of the car. The Indian will go and see the price tag of the car. He won't see anything else. He'll only see how much it costs. That is why cost is very important, especially in Indian context. Durability, the part should be highly durable. It cannot fail. Then recyclability and eco-friendly design. Now that the this pollution problem and also unnecessarily economic degradation, earth degradation of parts and water, all these things. So recyclability and eco-friendly design is very important. You must be able to use, in Germany, 100% of recycled material only should be used for a car manufacturing. You will be astonished. It was 10, 15 years back, it was 20, 30%. Now 100% only recycled material you can use. You cannot use fresh virgin material from mines. Then styling and appeal. That's very important for any customer to be proud of the new designs and styling and appearance. Then upgradability. You must be able to upgrade the product without much of a big restarting again from zero position. Then endurance. Endurance is like an airplane. The engine needs to be so much endurance, it should not fall down in between the air. Then manufacturability is a very important point, because you can't design a shape which is difficult to manufacture. Then easy maintenance, that comes under serviceability also. Maintenance also, even if the car is okay, maintenance like oil, putting petrol or any other thing, changing the washer, nut, easy maintenance should be there. Then regulatory and standards compliances. That's very important, especially with the pollution norms in Europe and America. It's very important to have that regulatory standards. Then safety and security. It should be safe to use. They are using the laptop for a bigger size. Yeah, this is in the phone, the letter were very small. So I have to see.
Safety and security is the next one.
Yeah, design success story I finished. Then I'm just this is over. Next is famous design is over. Pass 100%. I think I'm reaching to that 360 degree. Yeah, I'll come to this. Then comes minimalism. You should not use too many parts. As far as possible, the design should contain minimum number of parts functionally required. You should not unnecessarily add one dimension in a drawing. Will cost money. You know that? Inspecting that, or if the dimension is wrong, the parts will get rejected. So as far as possible, you reduce the number of dimensions on that. Then latest technology, you should use the latest technology in this. and interchangeability. That's very important. A bulb can go into any holder, isn't it? Like that, it should be interchangeable. Parts should be able to be interchangeable. And interchangeability comes to tolerance and allowance. Then only it will be interchangeable. That means more, the closer the tolerance, it will be more interchangeable. Then cultural aspects. This is also, that's why these are all coming at the end. After covering the main important things, we are now coming to the lesser important thing, but equally important for marketing point of view. Cultural aspects mean you will have to choose the colors liked by the people in Italy or Saudi Arabia or Pakistan or India, whatever is that. Different colors and shapes are liked by different countries. So you will have to see the aspect, cultural aspect. Otherwise, I can tell you, even graphic designs and product names are also very important. Hammam soap was not selling in Saudi Arabia because that is used when a man dies on the day, they use that name is called Hammam. So the Hammam soap was a total failure. I remember the example I'm just giving. Later on, they changed the name. Similarly, even giving the name or graphic designs or the, I think some graphic design made foot pad, some Ganpati's picture was put on the mat by Amazon or somebody, then it was culture. I mean, it is sentimental, affecting the sentiments. So cultural aspects are also equally important. Foolproofing is anybody should not assemble it in the wrong direction, like a cell phone SIM. You can only put it in one direction. You can't put it in any other direction. That's a very important aspect. In spare parts, you must be able to get the spare parts easily. That means it should not be a very, very special item. Otherwise, very, very necessity. Try to use standard. That standard parts applicable for spare parts also. Then energy efficiency. That is, of course, you understand that electric cars are energy efficient. So another 10 years, all petrol cars will go off. If they are more energy efficient and solar operated, all these things. Then transporting, packaging and transporting also very important. If you have designed everything nicely, but the packaging is bad. Packaging means the cell phone, batteries, chips, everything is okay, but the external shape of the thing is flimsy, it breaks or cracks or falls off. So packaging also very important at the end of the design. You must be able to consider this also as an important thing. Because you can't leave it as it is, because that is everything you have done nicely, but finally you see, for example, in Amazon, I received a package, 400 rupees item. They didn't put bubble packing, so it has cracked. So I had to send it back. So a lot of expenditure for the company just by saving maybe a 10 rupees packing, the whole thing has gone, is broken. So the packaging also very important. Any questions? If you have, you can ask me at the end. Next, please. Okay. User-friendly design. Now we are starting from each of those segments of the design. User-friendly design example is the TVS scooty. The scooty's petrol cap was below the seat. So every time it's used mostly by the girls. So they have to lick the seat and remove the helmet or whatever it is to fill the petrol. Now they have designed in such a way that petrol cap is at the behind the seat. So without opening the seat and standing there, they need not even put stand. They can directly, the petrol bug man can pour it, then they can close the cap. So that is a user-friendly example of a user-friendly, successful user-friendly design. So it should be like that. And like that umbrella also. The umbrella, previously you had to hold both the hands to open the umbrella. One hand on the handle, the other one on the clip. Then came the spring-loaded umbrella. With only one button pressing, it will go. So your other hand can carry a child or carry something else. So that's a good user-friendly design example. That way you will have to make sure that it is user-friendly. Next. Coordinate between phone and this. See, the seeds, we think seeds are very simple, but they are causing a lot of back pain and problem for the driver, fatigue, etc. So the valve of car seat is one example how, in fact, there are seats which adjust to the backbone curve of the driver. A short man sits, the seat will adjust. A tall man sits, it adjusts. A fat man sits, so the latest designs of seats are adjustable to each man's body. That's one of the good examples of ergonomic designs. Serviceability. Look at the servicing of nano car. For example, you will have to open the seats to approach the engine. It was not like a normal car where the dicky is opened and the engine can be repaired. I think later on they have changed the design. In the beginning, you have to remove the passengers from the back seat, then fold the back seat, then approach the engine from there. So serviceability was a big problem in those days. That's why serviceability is very important for mechanics or anybody to easily remove the wheel, easily remove the bonnet and take out the battery. The battery should not be cluttered somewhere, difficult to remove. So serviceability is important. Next, please. Next. Off-the-shelf parts. You will have to, as far as possible, this is an example, electronic items and screws. You must be able to use off-the-shelf parts in most of the items, screws, bolts, bearings, bushes, or rubber oil seals. You try to use, if it is 1 millimeter difference is there, doesn't matter. Use the standard part, half millimeter. Otherwise, it's extremely important to maintain your dimension. Due to some limitations, don't go for specially designed parts. These are all off-the-shelf parts. So you don't waste time on inventory, designing, manufacturing, and all these headaches are there. And then standard off-the-shelf parts will be used by anybody in India, anywhere. They need not wait for your spare parts to reach them. From your factory, it will be packed and dispatched to the dealer. All the headache will be over if you can buy it from the shop. Next, please. Cost. See, before globalization, of course, now the globalization is out of fashion now. 15, 20 years back, globalization was a buzzword. Now it is nationalization. Each nation has to look after themselves. No question of globalization and competing. For example, this slide may not be directly applicable to today's condition, but still, cost plus profit is the selling price in those days. Because we were like a Government of India surgical factory. A scissor may cost 40 rupees for manufacturing plus profit, they will sell 45. But in the market, it may be only 10 rupees. So cost plus profit is BML, HAL, HMT. These people were all doing this. Cost plus profit is selling price. But nowadays, selling price minus profit is the cost. You got the difference. We were enjoying, in our era, we were enjoying cost plus profit versus selling price. Now, whatever the Chinese makes, you try to reach the selling price of Chinese minus the profit which you need is the cost. So that way, cost is very important. Next one. Durability is very important. For example, take the case of the zip. When you want urgently push and if the zip doesn't open, you will be in soup. Like that, a lock also, it asks you when you want to reach home and open, try to open it. If that does not open, the key does not work, then you are in the soup. That's why we gave these two examples. So durability is very important. Because a zip may be operated 1,000 times before the pant tears off, maybe 5,000 times. So zip has to work correctly. Similarly, lock also. Next one. Recyclability is very important because of environmental thing and also ecological balance. You need the recyclability has become very important now. This is now known as a revolving economy. I think people can go to Google and see what is the revolving economy. That means you must be able to use recycled parts and use minimum parts. Unnecessarily, don't go for too many parts in your product. So
infinitely recyclable cans. In fact, Singapore recycles water 7 times, it seems. So you are not wasting the water. Drop of water, use 7 drops of water, it will become. So you'll have to recycle everything. You must be able to recycle. Nothing should be thrown. But the plastics cannot be recycled. But now they are cutting it and using it and laying roads, or some they make it. Some people in North India has invented something how to recycle the plastics by shredding it and making it like a thread. And I have seen in coir mats are replaced by waste plastics. They are colorful, very cheap, and lightweight. Good. That's a good idea, good innovation. Next one. Okay, eco-friendly design. The interesting fact is, this is Mr. Gandhi. His statue is there in Ford Motor Company in Michigan, because he invented the catalytic converter. His statue is next to Ford statue. Incidentally, you know, Ford is a Hare Krishna member. Ford, and he wears only dhoti and kurta, I think. This gentleman's statue is 10 or 20 feet away from the founder of Ford. They gave so much respect to this man because he invented the catalytic converter. What is catalytic converter? It removes all the carbon monoxide, lead, everything from the silencer, and pure air is coming out. May not be pure air, carbon dioxide maybe. Carbon monoxide, everything is removed by the catalytic converter. That is why he was given great respect. Then waterless washing machine, this I have not seen it. I have heard somewhere waterless washing machine also is there. Next one. See, the styling of a car is very important, because when you enter a showroom, you only see the beautiful aspect of the car, the color, shape, everything. It is equivalent to hook and bait. That means the bait attracts the fish, then it is hooked by the fishing line. So the customer is bait is the styling of the car. Then he enters into the showroom. First of all, you should make the customer to enter the showroom. No, so that is why it's the styling is very important. He gets hooked to the car. First, he is attracted to the car. Then he is hooked. And he buys the car. That is why styling, and in fact, styling engineers are paid very, very high, because they only make the appeal of the car. So one of the design, areas. Is industrial design, that is styling. That's very important. But everybody cannot become a stylist, because it requires natural flair and creative thinking, etc. Next one, please. Upgradability is, you all know that your computers can be upgraded or certain aspects of upgradation is possible in some of the electronic items, or adding some additional chips or additional features, can make it more video friendly or call or whatever it is. That means you must be able to upgrade the product without totally going for a new product. That also is part of the designers. But you may say the sale of the next version may come down if you upgrade. But many people do not want to totally go for a new product. If they can add some feature in the existing product, they will be happy. That is one. Upgradability is very important. Next one. Endurance is very important. As I can only think, endurance, maybe submarine or ships or drones. These are all very important for, and it has to withstand rain, lightning, plus it should run for hours, maybe 24 hours flight, it should not fail. So the endurance of products is very important while designing. You can't design a flimsy product and it may fail a short time. So you should have a very good bearings, very good heat dissipation, very good, you know, one spacecraft burnt while re-entering the earth, and that lady, Indian lady, died. I forgot her name. Bhatia, I remember. She is from Haryana. I am also from Haryana. So, in the endurance, it has failed. It could not withstand that heat while re-entering. Next, please. Manufacturability is very important aspect after the design is over. But the designer has to take care of the manufacturability also. Less machining, less assembly time, use of robots, less scrap, then less power consumption, less handling. You can't be handling it too. If you have got too many parts, you have to handle it too many times. Then alternative materials, lightweight, all are very simple. But all these aspects have to be looked into while designing. Easy maintenance. The girlfriends are costly to maintain, whereas old wife is easy to maintain. She will accept anything. So similarly, you cannot have a new design which are difficult to maintain. You should have fairly easy design. Then motorcycle battery, sealed batteries are less maintained. You don't need to pour water on that, and it occupies less space, and it's also compact for handling. So it's very easy maintenance, a very good aspect. Next one, please. Regulatory compliances is all radioactive material, building regulations that we looked into, then environment solutions, then wiring, IEEE wiring regulations. There are hundreds of regulations are there. Emission regulations, seat belt regulations. So many regulations are there, so you have to take care of the regulations also. Next. Next, please. Standards and compliances. You have to adhere to standards and compliances. Safety and security is a very important aspect, especially the speeds are increasing in the road. The children have started riding scooter and motorcycle, and housewives are using a lot of electric gadgets. Everything has to be, safety and security has to be assured. One small example here is a fan where it is guarded here, so you can't put your finger inside. Previously, it was open like that. So this is an evolution of design so that safety and security is taken care. Next, please. Examples of safe design is the boiler manhole. The manholes are elliptical in shape, so you insert it through the major, insert it inside and then close it from the inside of the boiler. So even if it explodes, the manhole cover will not come out. Then aircraft door, it is locked in such a way it can never open out. Then resale value. The resale values are both Japanese and this Korean designs and Swiss designs are all having resale value because they're very durable and long lasting, and performance is very good. Unlike the, but nowadays, use and throw type designs are coming because generations are changing. Now they want everything new type, new design, new color. So the resale value is only applicable to old people. We want to maintain that the resale value is there. Now everybody wants latest things, so they know. Next is minimalization. The minimalism is a good example is Lambretta and Vespa. Lambretta had more than 800 parts. Vespa may have only 500 parts. So minimalism design is not only it has avoided the chassis, it's a single sheet monocoque body like Maruti car. So the design has become simpler, number of parts are less, so you have less maintenance. More the parts, more maintenance. Similarly, control circuits, sometimes only 5 parts are used compared to the 50 parts. I don't know which it is. Apple. Okay, next one. use of latest technology. Yeah, of course, this you all know that you'll have to use the latest technology in any product. You can't have aluminium nowadays, or maybe instead of steel, aluminium, different kinds of plastics have come, and different types of controls have come, friction free materials have come. So use the latest technology as far as possible. Next is interchangeability. See, the example of so many types of chargers are there. If they can design it a single charge point, like a bulb, any bulb can be put in any holder, any bulb can go into any holder. No, that's a wonderful design. Here, everything has got a different connector. That's a bad design, but they have to do it because of their own independent countries. Some Japanese machines, some Korean machines, some Chinese machines like that. But the bulb is a good example of standard socket everywhere. Next is cultural aspect. This is a very intrinsic subject. It's difficult to understand unless you stay in that area and understand there. That's why they do market survey around the world. So the color, texture, shape, and weight. Maybe the Chinese are very short, so you can't use heavy items. The cars have to be shorter. You need not have a high, tall car, where Afghan people may require a very tall car. They are very tall. Then shape of the car, some countries like round shape, somebody like square shape. So the texture, then color. Color also, different countries have got their own interesting color choices. The price, of course, is a common factor everywhere. Especially in India, the price is a very critical thing to design at the time of designing. Next one. Foolproofing, we talked about it earlier. You cannot assemble anything in the wrong direction. You have to assemble it in the right direction. For that, the designer has to break his head how to make it foolproof. So LH thread or RH thread, or the cover has to go this way or that way, or the sim has to go. See, that small corner in the sim is a very good example of foolproofing. You can't put the sim in the wrong direction. That's a very good idea. I don't know how. See, for example, cell phone chargers in Samsung and all, you can put it only one direction, which is bad because people, old people may insert it wrongly and spoil the point. Now it is accepting both sides, like Apple iPhone. Apple iPhone was the first to do that. Now everybody is following that. You can insert the charger in any direction, no problem. Otherwise, it will damage the phone. It's a simple point, but they ignored it in the beginning. I don't know what the reason for that. Next one. Spare parts, of course, which we have discussed earlier. Spare parts must be easily available. Spare parts must work perfectly. And how do you change the spare parts? You can't design it where the spare parts putting is very difficult. So you have to think of spare parts also. Spare parts materials, spare parts availability. All these things have to be checked up in the beginning of the design. Next one. Energy efficiency, of course, both during manufacturing, you should try to use minimum energy. During usage also, then traditional coal-based energy forms, tidal, geothermal, wind energy, solar energy, all these energy are used. So the products have to exploit the minimum energy requirement by design such a way you don't increase the friction, you don't put a lot of resistance in that, and a lot of drainage of like a battery drainage. Like that, you have to design energy usage, efficient use of energy, both in manufacturing and use also. Usage also, you should consume less oil, less petrol, and less gas, something like that. Similarly, at the time of manufacturing also, you have to see that you use more energy efficient manufacturing process. So both have to be addressed. Then packaging and transport. See, packaging and transport, IKEA is a very good example of packing everything in a 5-inch width of box. They'll pack everything nicely. And also the packaging should not damage the parts we are transporting, and also packaging should be recycled packaging. So a lot of aspects in even in packaging and transportation, it should occupy less space. If you are having a handle projecting, you fold the handle so that it will occupy less space in the truck. Otherwise, you may need a bigger truck. So even that aspect has to be studied. I hope I make it clear. That be a saucer pan with a folding handle. So it doesn't, instead of occupying 12 inch, it may occupy only 6 inch. Next, please. Okay, the steps in relevant steps in designing: observe, then inspire, get inspired how to what to do on that, then innovate, then invent. After innovating in the mind, you invent it, then test it, then get a feedback from the customers, then improve the design, observe. So it's a continuous cycle. Every 2 years, the cars are, I understand, every day one Honda motorcycle is designed. I don't know whether to believe it or not. Similarly, the relevant steps are market research, then conceive, analyze the idea, then cost estimate, compare with the current products, then make sketches, detailed design. This is where the computers will be very helpful. Then prototyping, again, computerized 3D printing and all, very helpful. Those days it takes a lot of time to make a prototype. Now you can do it in a few hours. Then design for production, then documentation, and then patent. These are all the aspects of design fields. You may ask, where are the scope of job opportunity in IT? Everybody gets a job within, even before passing out. Where is the scope for a design field? I fully agree. There. Compared to software and hardware industry, hardware, of course, design is required, but so much scope is existing in so many fields, but design colleges are very few. In India, hardly, I think 10 design colleges are there, because we were always getting imported designs from collaborators. So there was no appreciation of design. Now they have started appreciating. A lot of design colleges are coming now. Even normal engineering colleges, they added design subjects. There are vehicle designs, transportation design like metro, railways, and agricultural machinery, tractors, combine harvesters like that, industrial machinery, then household products design, cooker, mixie, all these things, subsystems, then power engineering, aerospace, automobiles and bi-wheelers, material handling, oil and gas industries, green buildings, electronics designs, then communication design, then instrumentation, medical equipment. So many areas designers are required now. Previously, we were all getting it from abroad. So now, we have started doing ourselves. What is it? Mera Bharat something. Nowadays, you know? Atmanirbhan. So, it's very important. And these are all the areas you can go. Design vocations. Careers in design engineering. That is the fields where designs are applicable. Here it is careers. What are the different positions available? Designing products, detailed drawing. That is what Indians do for foreign companies. They send the drawing, we make the detailed drawing. Technical documentation. Again, we are asked. They outsource all this to India. Design appraisal. Then proposal engineering. If you want to propose a metro system, you have to design. Preparing standards. Research and development. Testing. Publishing, design verification, making design analysis, design software, design administrator, then proto building, and design illustration. If you are a good designer, come illustrator, get a lot of spare parts manual, this manual, service manual, then advertisement, all these design illustrations. Examples of software and detail drawing. Next, please.
Yeah. This is the last slide.
The last slide.
Yeah.
Software is cannot replace the brain and its ideas. When I was in Harita TVS, every boy was telling, I know Proe, I know Katia, I know this and that. I asked them, if I give you a very good pen, Can you write a poem? No, sir, I can't. Similarly, you can't be proud of knowing the software. There are only tools. Your brain has to work to design anything. So they were so much proudly telling that I know this software, this one, and then they realized it is not the software doing the design, it is your brain. Then software can speed up the work, it can multiply the work, it can repeat the work, it can calculate the work, it can analyze the work, but it cannot replace a human brain. Software is useful in testing, drafting, conveying ideas, 3D modeling, prototyping. Again, this is how useful. I think we have come to the last sign, I think. Okay. Four, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
So now, thanks for that detailed introduction to engineering design. So I think we can now open up for questions from the audience.
Okay.
So I'll just unmute everyone so people can start asking. If you wish, you can raise your hand and then I'll give you the chance to ask. So anyone wants to ask, you can ask, you can unmute yourself and ask. So I will start off. See, you said in one of the slides that globalization has given way to nationalism and cost may not be so important. Don't you think cost is still important, even though maybe in your view, globalization has become less important?
No, it's relatively only. Cost is very important. Any time of the world, cost is very important. But the globalization has made us to sacrifice certain costs. Like Chinese, they reduce the cost so much, they are able to compete, even though they may be at a loss. It may be compensated by the government, or it can be compensated by the communist policies and all, or they may give free land, free food, whatever it is. So in order to compete with them, globalization time, every country has to compete with other countries. Now, each country wants to depend on itself. There is no need to go for foreign countries. That is the stage which has come now. That is why everybody is trying to Atmanirbhar Bhavan, whatever now is going on, we also make it ourselves. So cost is very important, whether you have competition or not, because people won't buy it. You know, if you sell a scissor for 100 rupees, which is available for 20 rupees, government factories are making scissors for 100 rupees in Guindy surgical instrument factory. At that time, there was no globalization, nothing. But even then, people were compelled to buy it, all government hospitals were buying. So cost is an important factor perennially. But relatively, when there is no import competition, or you have got your own requirement and your own population, no need to worry about globalization. That is why nowadays, globalization word is not much used nowadays. Not only political point, it's cost.
Thank you for that. Anyone else has a question?
Yes, sir. Are you saying that, see, instead of manufacturing cost, sales cost is more important these days?
No, because manufacturing cost is somewhat reduced by the robotic application and also digitalization and all. So it has come down. But
No. Are you saying, you gave some equation, it was very interesting. I want to understand, now previously, sales cost was actually defined based on, our cost and profit we want.
Yeah.
Now, are you saying with globalization, sales cost is already fixed?
No, not
and global. The profit is also already fixed?
Market itself has fixed the cost roughly. They can afford only this much. Right. Globalization is now out of question now. Because it's all going to be only indigenization and local use, local market, local sales, everything. But the customers decide the price of this shoe, let us say 600 rupees. So you have to, profit is required by the management. So selling price minus profit should be the cost price. That means the manufacturing designers, everybody has to make it to that cost. Previously, any cost you make, put profit on that and sell it. It's reversed now. Am I clear?
Yes, yes. Now, who will decide the profit? It's again a corporate.
The profit. Management says, I want 10% profit to run the company. So, management decides the profit percentage. The market designed the selling price, so the engineers have to design the cost. The cost is due to the engineers, due to the designers, due to the manufacturing engineers, due to the workers. You use robotics or use any recyclable material, whatever it is, the cost is determined by the market and the management. Management cannot accept less than 10%, say, for example. I can't reduce, my profit has to be this. The market says this is the price for the phone. Then whose responsibility? It is the designer's responsibility, isn't it?
Sure, yeah. So cost also becomes a design constraint these days.
Yeah, that is why there are 360 degrees, cost is one other point.
Right. Thank you. All right.
Any other questions from others? So while people are thinking about their question, I have just a comment. Earlier you said about recycling plastic, where some people are using it to, you know, for making roads, for example.
Yeah.
You gave that as an example. So recently, I think only last week, I came across an interesting video where one guy, he has used a plastic bottle and from that he has made a plastic filament which can be used as raw material for 3D printing.
Yes, that is true.
So he has recycled the bottle to make a filament for 3D printing.
Yeah, a lot of people recycle, make fabrics, they make mattress. Instead of coir mattress, plastic is made into thin thread, they make mattress also. Like that, many people have started recycling the plastics.
So here, Sridhar has raised his hand, so let him ask his question. Sridhar, go ahead.
Okay, so you did mention that when someone goes into a car showroom, depending on the country, what they look for changes, right?
Not changes, what they look at, what they are keen to look at. Somebody okay, on the
so- So does designing your product or say whatever you're going to sell change based on your target audience or your, the country which you're planning to sell it in?
Exactly, exactly. If your major customer is Japanese, don't make the car too heavy, don't make it unnecessarily tall. You don't need a 2 feet gap for a Japanese passenger above his head. You can manage it 1 foot. That means that reduces the cost of the car, which is not required there. Similarly, Americans may like a large car with large, comfortable seats. Italians may look at a nice, beautiful looking, stylish car. Indian will look at the price tag. So you have to, that's why we de-specify a lot of cars for India. For export, we add all those features. Give you an example. My friend has imported a car from America. It happened 25 years back. He said, I want an air conditioner because there is no cold climate in India. So you remove the air conditioner. So what the company did, they put the air conditioner and send a bill, which is $1,000 more than the earlier cost. With air conditioner, it was cheaper. Without air conditioner, it was $1,000 more. So this Indian asked him, why you are charging me $1,000 more? I want a reduction. Then the American salesman said, sir, normally, all cars are going in a line without interruption. In your case, I have to take out the car from the conveyor line and put it separately and remove the air conditioner and put a dummy plate. For all this, the cost is $1,000. Then the Indians say, no, send it with the air conditioner. You got that? You got it or not?
Yes, I did. Okay, and I have another question. You did say that automation of the process will reduce the price, right?
Exactly.
Okay, so in case of automation, as of now, if you automate any process, you will be paying for the R&D cost and the fact that your machine has to be customized to the process that you're putting it in. So won't that add to the price and increase your final sales cost?
No, that is on the end product. I was telling the automation in the manufacturing. See, end product, any automation will cost more, but it will give comfort, see, like an automatic gearbox. You got only two pedals in automatic cars. where a normal car will have three pedals. So the automatic car gives you more comfort to the customer. So he won't mind paying more. In fact, in Bangalore, most of the cars nowadays are all hydrostatic drive. That means they are all automation, automatic gearbox or automatic transmission. That doesn't matter. The customer is ready to pay for the comfort. He has to change 100 times a gear between Indiranagar to Electronic City, isn't it? That fatigue is, so he doesn't mind paying if it is automated. What I meant was automation in the production area. That means you will use robots for assembly, robots for welding, robots for painting, because the robots don't go to toilet. Our boys will go to toilet and spend half an hour and come. Plus, consistency is better with automation, whereas human errors can come. That is why, plus of course, our country's problem is different. We got a lot of manpower. In Germany and all, the total car is produced without a single man. Right from the material going in, coming out, everything is automated. Nobody is there. Japan also. I have seen myself in Germany, total automation, because the number of people working are hardly 100. In India, it will be at least 1,000 people will be working. So that way, automation is very good for consistency of quality and production, uniform production. See, man's mood changes during tea time, lunch time, and while going home. So you, accordingly, quality also will get affected, you know.
Yeah.
Those things are overcome by the robots. So people may be against robots. Communists may say, why do you want robots? Lose them. But it is required now. Plus, hazardous areas. Where there are hazardous area, better to use a robot. Isn't it?
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Napoleon has raised his hand. Go ahead, Napoleon. You can unmute yourself and then ask your question.
Hello.
Hello.
Yeah. So if I say that automation, my question is, does robots still have a working time of like 8 to 10 hours with a supervisor, or it runs 24 to 20 hours in a day?
It works 24 hours. Robots do not take rest. They don't go to toilet. They don't go for tea. They work continuously.
But still supervisors are needed, right?
So that is for maintenance. See, mostly the robotic operations require highly skilled maintenance engineers, because they can't afford to break down the robot even for 10 minutes. Either they should replace the robot with another one or quickly repair it. That is why repairability is one of the very good aspects of design, serviceability, repairability and all. Robots work continuously, no rest for them.
So it is 24 hours productivity.
Exactly. See, the if you see the PCB boards, China, if you order today, day after tomorrow, your board comes by courier. I have seen it myself. You can see a YouTube video how they make PCB board. Even one board to 10 board to 1,000 boards, they so fast they make it. Nobody can beat them in the world. You can go and see YouTube PCB manufacturing in China. Everything is robotized. Surprising. That way they can feed the whole world with the chips. And we are all in chip problem now. There is no chips available, I think.
Can you tell me a little more about that chip lack or the insufficient the chips?
Chips is due to China's problem with China.
Okay.
Their container problems are there. In fact, our India doesn't. The container, a lot of container shortage is there. And China has got more than 10 crores, I think. 10 crores containers are there. We have only 1 crore. So container transportation problem, plus we are not trying to avoid Chinese products. So everybody in the world is in problem. China can produce the whole world requirement in 6 months' time. They got so much capacity. That's why I told you to see a YouTube Chinese chip production. Fantastic video. Can you believe you send your drawing through computer now, in 5 minutes it will go there. Next evening you will get the courier with the with the circuit board in your office. So fast they are doing. Unbelievable.
Thank you.
And whereas in India, we started a semiconductor factory in Chandigarh 60 years back. Anybody can remember that? It was closed in 1 year time. Today we are begging everybody to make the chips in semiconductor in India. We don't have that farsightedness we didn't have. Or it may be corruption. One of those two. I know this topic will be...
Huh? Sorry, Ralph had a question, I think.
Ran out of questions?
Ralph. Yeah. Okay, maybe not. Yeah. Anyone else has a question?
No, nothing.
So I think earlier in the talk, Mr. Krishnan mentioned, a lot of this will be applicable to IT, particularly to hardware.
Yeah.
But I would like to add a comment that even for software, many of these things matter. For example, when designing software, we normally think of testability as well. That is one of the things we look at when designing software. Then obviously upgradability, UI, UX is involved. So there are a lot of principles here which can be applied to software. Maybe not all of them, but definitely quite a number of them are applicable to software.
I do agree, because I am a mechanical engineer. I cannot so much appreciate the applicability, but all these rules are standard even for software, no doubt about it, except it is not physical. It's all abstract. That's all. Here everything is physical, whatever we discussed. In your case, the testing, then upgradability, then the debugging, all these problems may be there, which can be addressed by the designer, no doubt. I fully endorse your view, because these slides are all mostly prepared for mechanical designs, mechanical, electrical, electronics, like that. That way I couldn't cover much on the software side.
Thanks for clarifying that. Any other questions? Okay, if not, then we'll conclude here. Thanks for joining the call. Maybe in a couple of days or maybe tomorrow, by tomorrow, this video will be available on YouTube. You will get the link. Our next talk in the series is day after tomorrow, on Friday, same time, 7 p.m. If you have registered, you will get the invite. So if nothing else, we'll take leave now. Thanks for joining the call. Thanks, Mr. Krishnan, for that insightful talk.